In this tutorial, we're going to be looking at using the Simple Mind mapping program for setting up to do argument mapping. And the website from which you can obtain this program is simpleapps.eu/simplemind with another slash. And they've got different apps available. So they've got an Android app that currently I think is about $6, as is their iPad and iPhone app. They've got a desktop version for the Mac and a desktop version for Windows. The version that I'm going to be using for this tutorial is the Windows desktop version. I assume that everything that we do in this version is also doable on the Mac. Of course, you'd be using slightly different ways to access the menu items and those things on the Mac. I believe, but I don't know, that all of the functionality is also available through the iPad and Android apps. I do know that if you take a look at those, they have free versions of those available. So they have this Simple Mind Plus version, which is initially downloaded as a free version that does not have the functionality that you would need even to do some of the simple setup stuff that we're going to be doing here. So if you are intending to try to do this with the iPhone or iPad or Android app, you would need the Pro version that presumably would give you all of the functionality that we'll have on this desktop version that we're going to be looking at. Now, I'm not going to be going into a lot of details on use of this program itself, just kind of the basics that you need for doing some argument mapping, but I would suggest that you get in and on their website, they've got links to most of their help functions. So if you go to the editor help, a lot of really good stuff here to get you started with the basics, kind of how to interact with this program, get a sense of its functionality. So I'd suggest that you go in and use that help. Additionally, go over to the frequently asked questions section, and they've got a lot of good information here to get you familiar with some of the full functionality of this program. So once you've got Simple Mind downloaded and installed, you'll open it up and we'll just start on a new blank map. And before we get started with trying to do argument mapping, it's going to be really handy and helpful to just kind of go through and do some basic setup things. It'll basically constrict the format on these maps so that it's a little bit more amenable for this particular application. So what we're going to do first is we're going to set the overall style for our maps. You're going to go into the visual style and go to the global style options. And then in here, let's go over to the general tab. You can look through here, there's a lot of different settings that you can adjust and things, but the things that I'm going to focus on are kind of the bare necessities just for setting this up for doing some argument mapping. And you'll see on this general tab, if you come over here and look at these different layouts that they've got available, there's what, five different general layouts, and you would think when you look at this, it would make sense that this top-down layout might work best for us because that generally has the structure where you've got one item at top and then some generally a tree structure kind of thing below it. However, this one is actually too constrained for our use. It doesn't give you the flexibility to move things around like we want, and it would just get frustrating. So what you want to do is set this on the freeform layout. And we'll use that for the argument mapping. We'll just make sure that we've got them constructed according to the standard argument map flow, where you've got your conclusion at the top and then premises and counter arguments and things below it. So let's do that and apply that change. And then the main other thing that we want to do is just set up kind of the overall style so that it generally uses the colors that we want, and we can predefine some settings in here to make it real easy once you get going. So let's go again back to this visual style menu item,
And let's edit a style sheet. We can look at, you can click on this style sheet and see, various styles that they have available, but we want to create our own that's exclusive for argument maps. So let's click on Edit Style Sheet, and it'll bring up this custom style editor. And in here, you're going to set the default colors, format for the connectors and that kind of thing for argument maps in general. And so we're going to stick with the convention that we had talked about. We'll leave the conclusions, our central topic, which will be our conclusion node or conclusion box, we'll leave that with this blue formatting. But all the other connecting nodes to that, let's go ahead and set those with a green color. Generally, most of those are going to be premises in support of that. And then we'll come in and I'll show you how to set a couple other settings for the other two colors that we want to use, one for counter arguments, one for basis boxes. But for our map layout in general, let's do this. So the first thing we want to do is just, let's come in here and set this to use colors per level. This will just speed this process up for you a bit, I think. And so let's go ahead and select on any of these nodes, children nodes, to that main node, and let's go ahead and pick a green color. I'll use this kind of a moderate green here, and note that I had this checkbox checked to derive stroke color when selecting the fill color. The stroke color is the color of this outside border on these nodes, so it puts it, when you do that, it just makes it a darker version of the interior color. And then the other thing that I'm going to want to do here is set the, since I'm using kind of a dark green, I want to make that color for the fonts white so that it shows up well on there. That's going to set that for all of the nodes. If we want, we can come back in and change it individually when we're done for that conclusion setting. Okay, so that should have set, oh yeah, okay, so that sets that, the number two here then would set that for all second level nodes. It's not clear from the way they have this laid out. The map doesn't really correspond to what it's doing when we've got this colors per level thing. So let's, maybe we'll end up with, let's say, maybe four or five levels of argument. It just depends on how complex your arguments are going to be. If you want, you could go through and set this for all eight of those. You can actually add in some additional levels as well, but I'm just going to use those same settings. And all we need to do is just go and select each of those nodes, set the color to the color that we want. And now, once, when we're using this template, whenever we create a map, it will use these predefined colors for each of these layers. The other thing that I'd like to do, I'll just go ahead since I'm here and set it for all of the levels that are showing, I guess. And finally that one. And then the other thing that we want to do while we're in here is go ahead and set a couple settings in this hierarchical relation tab down here at the bottom. So one, I prefer to kind of have solid lines, not a big deal, but I just think it makes the maps a little bit cleaner. And then it is important, probably for most of the stuff we're going to do, come in and use this angled line instead of the curved line. That's going to make the relationships and moving things around, that kind of thing, I think a bit easier if we do that. I think that's really all the settings that we're concerned with in this particular place. So let's go ahead and save that. The first time we do that, it'll let us give a name, and so I'm going to call that new style argument map and set that. So we've closed that style sheet. Now we can come in and select it on this new map. It should show up down here at the bottom, argument map. That's the one we just created. And we can, let's come in and test this real quick. So if I select that central node and let's add a topic to it, sure enough, it does a green one. Let's put something in there so this would be like premise 1, and if we add another, I could do a sibling node from here by clicking on that. You see it's got the colors right. This map is, I had already had this one created apparently, because this is using this top-down structure. So that's fine. Let me just go ahead and close this one. We'll delete that map, and let's just start a new map. And I guess before we start that, let's come in and set our style sheet to use this argument map style. And now let's look and see what the arrangement is when I add a topic. So sure enough, it is using that angled connector. And when I add nodes in here, it's going to use that green color setting that we set for the argument map. And importantly, let me come in here and add this in as well. Importantly, with using this free form approach, it's going to allow us to kind of move these supporting premises and boxes nodes around however we want to do that. So that's why we use the free form style. Now, just one other little thing that we want to do here is we want to set some style settings, some style presets that will handle the other couple colors that we want to use here. And I kind of like, in this lighter colored box, I like to have the font in black, so we'll use we wouldn't have to, but we can set a style preset for that one as well. So let's look at how to do that. And it's really quite simple. We're just going to use these two buttons, the style presets and the add new preset button. So basically we'll just come in and I'll right click on my conclusion node here, and all I want to do here is just change the color for the font. So we'll change text color and I'll select black font there. So once you've applied any formatting to a node, you can just come up to this add a new preset based on those attributes. We can give it a name, so in this case we'll call that one our conclusion preset. There's some other settings. You can come in here and modify those things, but that's basically like I want it, so we'll say okay. I may at times want to be able to come in and apply this premise formatting independently, so let's just go ahead and set a preset for that one as well. I hadn't customized that one. So once we make some changes in there, let me show you on a counter argument. I guess it'll make a little bit more sense. So let's come in. Let's say we add a node. I set every level, remember, in the argument template to be green, but occasionally I am going to want to have a counter argument perhaps, and I want to have those colored a little bit differently. So let's set the box color, fill color, we'll make it something kind of a light red, and then in this case I'll come in here and manually adjust the color for the frame around that would be the stroke color here, and let's make it just a darker version of that. So that's what my counter arguments would look like. And once you've applied that formatting, then just go ahead and create a preset. In this case, I've already used this one, I think, but I've named these pro and con or pro arguments and con arguments. Let's just see if it'll take that one, maybe rewrite over it. Yep, good. So I could do the same thing then, come in here and, for the other one that we want to have is our basis boxes. So when you get down to the lowest row of your argument, kind of the foundational arguments, you're going to want to include these basis boxes, which include the evidence support in for each of those baseline kind of premises. So we want to have those stand out. And in this case, I've just been using let's come in here and right click and just pick a color and was using something kind of over here. And green outline on that one is fine. You can change that if you'd like. And then let's set that one as a preset, and we'll just call that a basis. So once those are in there, as you're working along, you come in, let's say we add we add in another premise over here. Maybe I want this to be a counter argument. And I want to apply that setting, so once I've got that node selected, then I can just come in here, pull up this, click on this button. This will pull up my presets, so you can see there's the ones that I just created, the conclusion, the con, and the base. Looks like with conclusion, yeah, all it did was just change that. It saved that black font color change that I did. So if I want to make that a counter argument, that's all I need to do now. Those are saved in SimpleMind now. I won't have to do that for every map. Both the style sheet and those style presets are now saved in there. So the next time you come in and start building an argument map, you can just use those. So the other thing then, as you're going on, now that you've got this set up, as you're building these arguments, you can come in and move any of these items around independently. If I just click on it and drag it, I can move that independently. A lot of times you're going to want to move a whole branch of an argument. Maybe we've got another supporting premise over here, etc. You've got, you know, kind of this whole branch built up. So just in the Windows version, the Windows desktop version, just click and hold it for about a second, and you'll see it'll select that entire branch, so you can move that whole branch around. Okay. The other thing that you're going to want to be able to do is to attach a given node or a whole branch to a different node. So in this case, let's do that with this branch. Let's take this whole premise one branch, and I'm going to attach it as a sub argument over here for premise two. So I'll just click it, hold it for a second, and get the whole branch. And then if I drag it and drop it, you can see that shading around the premise two box. It knows, so you know that it's going to attach that now to that other node. And it did. It kind of put it where it wanted it, but that's no problem. I'll just click and hold it now that it's attached to that one, and then I can kind of move it around wherever I want. So you've got complete control over the layout of these things. You'll be able to structure these so that you've got your more fundamental arguments down below. This wouldn't be a good layout. You would probably want to have this one over here in some such way. Generally, your basis boxes are going to link off of the baseline kind of premises, so something like this might be a reasonable kind of arrangement for one branch of this argument, and you could have another branch over here, etc. So that's really all you need to know to be able to set up this program for doing some pretty effective argument mapping. The final thing that I wanted to give you some insight into is how to export these so that you can upload them easily into Canvas. And all you're going to need to do is go over here to the main menu and come down the mind map item on the menu, go down to export mind map. You've got a couple different options there. You can export as these free mind files. Don't use that one. We want to get a format that's easily uploadable through our course management system, which is Canvas. So you could use, the easy ones to use would be either the PDF file or even just a PNG image file. So you can just export that, and I'll just make a picture of it. You can save it wherever you want on your desktop. So if I do that, then saves that. Then when you go into Canvas, just upload that PNG file, and those should work fine. If you happen to have trouble with that, you could always do a PDF file that would essentially do the same thing. And that should be it.